Have you ever heard the expression, diamonds are a girl's best friend? Do you think there's any truth to that? Why would it be true? It's because diamonds are pretty special minerals. And in today's video, we'll have a look at what makes diamonds so special. We'll learn what diamonds are, how diamonds are formed naturally, and where diamonds come from. Hello, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, I'm Maria, and I'm a scientist and a sci-fi fantasy writer sharing with you the wonders of our world. And today's wonders are diamonds. Why diamonds? Because I'm always searching for new ideas on how to better develop the alien worlds that I create in my novels. And in my quest to create these new alien worlds, I came across some older news regarding the discovery of a planet made entirely of diamond. While later research suggested that it might not actually be made of diamond, it's still an interesting idea to explore, and I thought we could explore diamonds together since we also have diamonds on our planet. First, we will see what diamonds are made of. Then, we will see how diamonds are formed naturally. And finally, we will see which are the locations on Earth where diamonds are most abundant. And if you stay until the end, I will tell you about some other uses of diamonds outside the jewelry industry. First of all, what are diamonds? And what are diamonds made of? Diamond is an allotrope of carbon. Now you probably wonder, what is an allotrope? Allotropes are different structural forms of a certain chemical element. To clarify, that means that there are different possible ways to organize the atoms of one single chemical element to create different three-dimensional structural arrangements of that element. For example, some allotropes of carbon include diamond, graphite, fullerenes, and others. The carbon allotrope we're interested in here is diamond. What you see here is the unit cell of diamond. It's what we call the crystal structure of diamond. The unit cell of diamond is the basic unit, which when translated in all the directions in space, creates the crystals that we know as diamonds. The tight tetrahedral arrangement of the carbon atoms in the diamond structure, together with the very strong bonds between these carbon atoms, makes it extremely difficult to break these bonds. In fact, it is so difficult to break the chemical bonds in diamonds that the only material known to be able to cut or scratch a diamond is another diamond. This makes diamonds perfect for the jewelry industry because diamonds will maintain their polish even if they are worn for a very long time. So now we know that it's very difficult to break diamonds. But how are they formed that they are so difficult to break? Let's see how are diamonds formed naturally. And here I say naturally because we can also grow diamonds artificially in labs through a process called chemical vapor deposition. But that is not the topic of this video. Here we want to see how natural diamonds are formed. In the previous video, we saw how the volcanic rock coming from the cooling of lava from volcanic eruptions is responsible for the different colored sand beaches. But there is something much more precious that we can find in volcanic rocks. You guessed it, it's diamonds. In order to form diamonds, huge pressures and temperatures are needed. We find these kinds of conditions that are perfect for diamond formation in one of the Earth's inner layers, the mantle. The mantle is the layer between the Earth's crust and its outer core. The high pressures in the upper mantle compress the carbon atoms together in the closely packed crystal structure that we observe in diamonds. Applying pressures of about 45 to 60 kilobars under temperature conditions of up to 1300 degrees Celsius is the natural process through which diamonds are formed in the Earth's mantle. But if diamonds are formed inside the Earth, how do they get to the Earth's surface? Diamonds were carried upwards from the mantle towards Earth's surface by the lava originating in deep volcanic eruptions. These violent volcanic eruptions happened billions of years ago when Earth was much hotter. The lava from these violent eruptions traveled at very high speeds towards Earth's surface through vertical structures, breaking the Earth's crust. This magma brought with it mantle rocks, including the volcanic rock called Kimberlite. These volcanic rocks then cooled upon reaching the Earth's surface. The vertical tunnels through which the magma traveled to the Earth's crust are called kimberlite pipes. And it is inside these kimberlite rocks that we find the diamonds that were formed billions of years ago in the Earth's mantle. So next time you admire a beautiful diamond jewelry, just remember that it's a gemstone formed through reactions that took place billions of years ago deep beneath the Earth's surface. That's a pretty ancient and expensive piece of heritage we have from our planet. So now we know where diamonds originated from, but where on Earth can we find diamonds now? Where do diamonds come from? They come from the diamond mines established in the locations where the magma containing diamonds broke through the Earth's crust and created the kimberlite deposits. The countries with the highest diamond production are Russia, Botswana, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Australia, and Canada. These are only the five biggest diamond production countries, but there are other countries around the world that have large diamond production. If you want to see a list of all the diamond mines in the world, I added a link for you in the video description. Depending on the conditions under which the diamonds were formed, they can have different colors. Diamonds have different colors either because of impurities trapped in the diamond structure, or because of certain defects in the lattice, or because of the effects of radiation on diamonds. We'll see which one of these causes is responsible for which color of diamonds as we go through the different diamond colors in the next video. So if you don't want to miss that video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button so you get notified when I upload new videos. And now, as I promised you in the beginning, let's talk about the applications of diamonds. But before discussing the diamond applications, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy learning about diamonds. Let's see now, what are the applications of diamonds? Besides the all romantic, will you marry me, overpriced way of showing your love towards someone, we also have some more useful applications of diamonds. In fact, only about 20% of the mined diamonds are used in jewelries as gemstones. The other uses of diamonds are focused on industrial and research applications. These include the use of diamonds for cutting, grinding, and polishing materials, including other diamonds. Diamonds can also be used in diamond windows in research equipment, in diamond speaker domes in high-quality speakers, for engraving granite and quartz, and even in medicine for drills in dental tools. And nanodiamonds even have potential uses in cancer research for monitoring how well the cancer medication works in cancer patients. Diamonds are also being used in nuclear magnetic resonance, or NMR. If you want to learn more about NMR, you can check out this video that I prepared explaining the basic principles of NMR. In NMR, researchers use nitrogen vacancy or NV centers in diamonds to increase the sensitivity of NMR experiments. They do this in order to be able to record NMR experiments on much smaller sample volumes than in conventional NMR. And finally, my favorite application of diamonds, creating new forms of materials by exposing them to high pressures. In materials research, scientists use what we call diamond anvil cells to induce high pressures in materials. We do this by pressing together two diamonds, as you see in this picture. As we press together the two diamonds, we induce high pressures in the material that's in between the diamonds. This helps researchers study the properties of materials, monitor phase transitions in materials, and possibly create new high-pressure phases of materials with improved properties. Let me know in the comments which one of these diamond applications you think is most interesting. I hope you enjoyed learning about diamonds and seeing what diamonds are made of and where and how they are formed naturally and learning about some of the diamond applications. And in the next video, we will learn about the diamond colors, and there are many of them. So I hope to see you there. Bye!